later. So now we'll see actually your trusses now, or statically determinate structures. Now in this actually we are going to read your truss. Right now, when we study the trusses, so in this trusses or your this trusses when we are going to read, we are going to find out the forces in these members of the trusses. And all these trusses, whatever we are going to read actually, this will be all be statically determinate structures. So we are going to follow the method of statically determinate structures. And we are going to follow only three equations, that is summation of x, summation of y, and summation of moment equal to zero. So we are going to follow only these three conditions to find out the forces in the trusses. Now, when you want to find out the forces in trusses, basically there are two methods, or you can, four methods are there basically. First method is known as your method of joints. Second method is method of section. Fourth method is actually your tension coefficient method. You should actually know the name of the methods. What are the methods actually which are used to solve the problems? Because sometime in year 2009, they have asked actually the method for one problem. Okay, so that's why I'm giving you the method name also. You should just write it down. And next is actually your graphical method. So these are the four methods actually which is being used to solve or to find out the forces in the member of trusses. If you want to find out what is the force in this member, if there is a load here, then what are the forces actually in the members? So we can use this any four methods and then we can find out the forces. But for gate point of view and for your B.Tech course, we have to only read this method of joints and method of section. And when you are solving for your gate examination, you have to restrict yourself to only method of section, not method of joint. So now, next thing is, first thing we'll see actually your zero force member. So when we are solving any problem, when we are solving any problem in a truss, there will be several members. There will be several members. And in the exam, what can happen? They may ask you to find out force in this member. When you're writing your semester examination, that time they will ask you to find out the forces in all the members, right? But when you're writing your gate examination, that time they may ask you that to find out the force in only one particular member or something like that. So in the exam they may ask you to find out the force in this member or two members or three members, not in all members. So in the exam actually, they will, semester exam, they will ask you to find out the force in all members. But to find out the force in single member, we'll actually use method of section, and to find out the force in all member, we'll use actually your method of joints. So to solve actually method of section, we'll have to first understand what is actually your method of joints. Okay, so now for understanding method of joints, write down what are the assumptions. What are the assumptions actually for finding out the forces? What are the assumptions you can write down? Write down the assumptions. The individual members are straight. The individual members are straight. Individual members are straight. Second is, individual members are connected by frictionless hinges. Individual members are connected by frictionless hinges. Third point, loads and reaction act only at the joints. Loads and reactions act only at the joint. Loads and reactions act only at the joint. Next important thing is zero force member. There will be some members in the truss or some members in the exam which actually surely will be zero force member. Whatever problem will come in your gate examination, in those problems you will have some members which will have actually zero force. So we have to identify first before solving any problem which members are having actually your zero force member. So for that there are three basic shortcuts or three basic concepts how we can find out your zero force member. So now you can write down zero force member. Okay, we will discuss this now. Let us see actually how we will discuss this in a very more efficient way. Let me, I'll just explain you, try to make it very simpler. Because whatever I'll teach, I'll try to make it very simple and we'll see actually how you can solve the problems in the GATE examination. Let me discuss that. So first we'll discuss actually your zero force member, how you find out actually in a member, in an exam, which members are having actually your zero force member, okay? First thing, write down, a single member cannot be in equilibrium. Yeah, we'll discuss only problems. A single member cannot be in equilibrium. Point number one, write down. A single force or single member, a single force cannot form, a single force cannot form a system in equilibrium. A single force cannot form a system in equilibrium. A single force cannot form a system in equilibrium. That means this member will have, if there is a single member, that means the answer will be actually this member will have zero force member. Second point, if two forces act at a joint, if two forces act at a joint, if two forces act in a joint, then for equilibrium of the joint, then for equilibrium of the joint, two forces should act along same straight line. Two forces should act along same straight line. Otherwise, they must be zero. Otherwise, they must be zero. Next point. So the meaning is, if there are only two members, that means if there is a joint and there are two members, suppose if they are in mutually perpendicular, if they are in same direction, in that case both of them have to become a work will be actually equal and opposite. If there are two members and they are acting at a joint, then they will be equal and opposite for vertical equilibrium, for equilibrium. If they are not in the same line, then they will be zero. We'll see this, how you can use this to solve problems. And third and very important point, this is the most important point, if at a joint there are three members, if at a joint there are three members, and if member one and member two are in the same line, are in the same axis, means this is pulling this and this is pulling that, so the third member is going to have actually zero force member. And this is the most important concept, this and this, which you should understand. So you can write down, if three forces, third point, if three forces act at a joint, if three forces act at a joint and two of them are along same straight line, and two of them are along same straight line, then for equilibrium of joint, the third force should be zero. The third force.